Italian film director Luca Guadagnino is best known for his stunningly aesthetic films that capture emotional connection to his homeland. The perfect example of these visual aesthetics appears in the director's critically acclaimed Desire trilogy, comprised of I Am Love, A Bigger Splash, and Call Me By Your Name. Despite these films' success in the United States, he has constantly struggled with the Italian cinema's audiences and critics because they view him as unconventional and his films as un-Italian. However, despite Guadagnino's distance from the traditional Italian film establishment, his nonconformist films are nevertheless distinctly Italian because of his attachment and devotion to aestheticizing the national and cultural landscape. The Italian landscape is no stranger to the big screen. It is a motif that has made quite a name for itself. From the rolling hills to hazy pink horizons so desired and featured in both Italian and international film, the country's landscape has come to symbolize ultimate romance in films and reality. However, this landscape can often be, according to Guadagnino, quote, mostly a bureau for tourism, end quote, something he often references in A Bigger Splash. In order to combat the stereotypical Italian landscape, yet still heavily profile it in his films, he goes on to explain, quote, I am more interested in revolutionary beauty than in the great beauty, end quote. And for Guadagnino, this revolutionary beauty is realized through the exploration and illustration, a desire for love and landscape.
How do you film desire? That was the question I posed to myself.
The Desire trilogy explores the sensuality of Guadagnino's geocultural Italian landscape aestheticization. Writer and film critic Joanna Di Mattia specializes in studying the aesthetics of desire and claims the Desire trilogy, quote, arouses the audience's own desire and encourages scopophilic pleasure in the sight of beautiful people luxuriating in delicious Italian locations, end quote. This is particularly seen in I Am Love, when Emma and Antonio make love at his country house. These Italian landscapes prove just as intensely gorgeous as the characters making love in the lush, organic brush, especially when A Bigger Splash's seductive atmosphere is paired with the pent-up desires for youth, love, and luxurious vacation on the island Pantelleria near Sicily.
I think the island feels like a character in the film.
Guadagnino's connection to the Italian film industry occurs when he binds the Italian landscape to his protagonist's romantic toils.
Look at this.
His third venture in the Desire trilogy, Call Me By Your Name, released in 2017, is a very personal and artfully mastered piece of cinema that capitalizes on dreamy northern Italy in the summer of 1983 to paint landscape views as rich as the story. Guadagnino feels very personally connected to this film because he was 2 years younger than Elio is in the book, and he is openly gay. Most notable, though, is his personal investment in location, which spotlights his persistent dedication to his homeland, particularly evident in the fact that Elio Perlman and his family live in Villa Albergoni in Crema, Italy. This charming location is also where Guadagnino currently resides, in his apartment above a 17th century palazzo, only 40 minutes from I Am Love's Milan. In the film, nature acts as a metaphor for Elio and Oliver's safe haven to discover their own love for each other. Guadagnino's intricate attention to these landscapes and environments allows him to successfully capture a pastoral and favorable view of his homeland. One such landscape is the Villa Albergoni's garden, created by Guadagnino's landscape designer and friend Gaia Chaye Giusti. Much of the exquisite Perlman Estate's landscape is, in fact, artificially created, particularly the orchard and pool. Furthermore, the heavenly sights and sounds of other famous Italian wonders, such as Lake Garda in Sirmione, the largest lake in Italy, for Elio, Oliver, and Professor Perlman's archaeological dig, stands out as moments when the landscape nudges the two lovers together. Another such instance occurs when Elio and Oliver ascend the Cascate del Serio, Italy's tallest waterfall, before going to Rome. The new but ephemeral couple are out in the world, but still in a safe, natural Eden with no external conflicts. These diversions from the soft and comfortable home and garden narrative display national landscapes that point to the grand beauty of Italy and still nurture the two lovers' romance. The landscape acts as a character that protects and encourages Elio and Oliver to find each other.
Elio! Oliver!
Beyond filmmaking, Guadagnino is concerned with design to an impeccable and perhaps extreme degree. This desire and thirst for painted sets shines through and has become an obsession of fans, particularly featured on the Instagram account Call Me By Monet, which has 65,000 followers. The account plays upon the impressionistic backdrops of Call Me By Your Name in a way that lovingly acknowledges the dreamy environment which Elio and Oliver thrive in, also a nod to the famous Monet's berm scene. In the edits posted by Call Me By Monet, the two young men are set against various Monet paintings, such as The Wheat Field, The Parc Monceau, and Camille Monet at the Window Argenteuil. While his own industry criticizes him for that which separates him from Italian cinema, Guadagnino's films are irrefutably crafted by the hand of an Italian artist. He instills his own love for his country in his films, even when Italian audiences and critics cannot find a place for him among their own. He has created a name for himself that sets him apart from the establishment, using the beautiful and sometimes frighteningly geopolitical national landscapes to reflect his own dedication to capturing images that make Italian cinema so renowned.